Pressing an arrow key on one of the optional keypad bezels will move the focus from one object on the screen to the next. For example, if I press the right arrow, this object now has the focus. If I press it again, the focus moves to this one, that one, this one, and then finally back to the first one. The order in which that happens is normally controlled by the order in which the parts are placed on the screen. After moving the parts around, though, that may not work, as you can see in this example where we went all over the screen every time we pressed the right arrow. The good news is, you have complete control over the order in which that happens. For example, it'd be great if when we hit the right arrow, we tabbed from left to right, this first key to the second key to the third key, then the fourth key and the fifth key, instead of this random pattern we had a minute ago. Let's see how to do that. You can set up the arrow key tab indexing either in the Navigation Windows Function tab under Tab Index or under Setup, Tab Index. On this screen, you can see the current tab index. Here's number 1, 2, 3, 4, and over to 5, just like we saw in the demo. To change it, just click on the object you want to change and edit it here. So for example, we want this to be the first object that we tab to, so we'll change him to a 1, so I change that 5 to a 1. He's number 2. We want this guy, which is currently number 4, to be 3, so I just hit the 3, and that turned this guy to a 4 and that guy to a 5. Normally that would be okay, because we would arrow from 1 to 2 to 3 to 4 to 5. But it would be nice if the up-down arrows could take us down to the next row. Well, there's a trick for that. The up-down arrow keys increment the index by 10. So if you number the lower row with an offset of 10, the up-down arrow keys will move the cursor up and down a row. Let's do that. Let's make this guy 1 plus 10 would be an 11. And let's make this guy a 13. A few notes. If you have a background screen with objects on it, those objects would be listed here and you can specify a tab order for them too. Number 2, the tab order is by screen. So if we go to screen 2, we can set up another tab order for this screen. Let's do that real quick. If we bring up our tab index, we can see things are all messed up here. So let's make this tab 1, 2, 3, and we want this guy to be 10 more than the one above it, so that makes him an 11, and we should be good to go. Let's try it and see how we did. Now, if everything worked the way we expected, when I hit the right arrow, this guy should get the focus. And he does. The guy to the right of him, the guy to the right of him. Next row, like that. Now the up-down arrows should take me up a row, down a row, and likewise. Okay, that screen looks good. Let's head over to screen 2. The first object should be the upper left, and it is. Move to the right, and then down a row, and the up and down arrows work exactly as planned. So now all of our objects on all of our screens move in a very natural order as the user hits the arrow keys. Well, that's all there is to setting up arrow key tab indexing. Be sure to check out the other videos in this series. And as always, please send us any topics you would like to see covered, or any other comments for that matter. We appreciate the feedback.